man. So kind of how I record making SP404 MK2 beats is I just kind of do them live. To me, this instrument, it's a live instrument. So what I do mainly is I will use the resample function. So after I load up my samples, right, and I will play, you know, play around with them. If you can hear that, you probably can't hear that right now, but I play them. Here's the, you know, you're seeing the sample right there, and I would do the skip back function, right? I think you hit shift and start and end, I think, right? And it'll play what you've played back. I'm not sure how many minutes. Hold up. I thought that was it. Maybe it's is it Mark? Or is it? Yeah, you hit Mark. You hit Mark to play back what you played like in the last whatever minute. So after I've been jamming, I go back here and see what I like, and I, you know, trim it up, get my start and end points or whatever, like, and then I will sign that to one of the pads, and then once I have it, I'm gonna just hit cancel in this case. Once I have it on the pads, I'm going to play this live, perform it live into something like my Pro Tools, right? And here I got just a template that I use for when I'm doing two tracks sessions on there. And so, yeah, that's pretty much why I use the SP. I may use it just to, you know, to get an idea and throw it into something else, my MPC or Ableton or something, you know, to further create. A lot of times I just two-track it in, perform it, do some little mix and master on two-track and call it a day. Maybe do some arrangement on it and call it a day. So, so check this out. So I tried to record live my process of what I'm just talking about. Hopefully it came out. So here it is.
Smell.
Give it a way out. Is that kind of your approach to it? Like, okay, before I have to fuck over you.
I don't call it a way out.
Always give them a way out. Is that kind of your approach to it? Like, okay, before I have to fuck over you.
I don't call it a way out,
but I'm
feel like everybody is due a chance. You know what I mean? I really feel that way because I feel like if some people know better, they'll do better.
Way out. Is that kind of your approach to it? Like, okay, before I have to fuck over you.
I don't call it a way out. But I just feel like everybody is through a change. You know what I mean? I really feel that way because I feel like if some people know better, they'll do better.
So here you see me, I am now getting in the mixing and mastering for the two-track. I kind of do it all one and the same here. So I am not sure what happened to my sound. I have Universal Audio interface, and I'm still learning it, so forgive me for that. So that's a RC20, which is always good on these SP404 beats. It gives you that old record static lo-fi feel. Sometimes you gotta watch on the EQ though on those things, because they cut out a lot, you know. Just depending on the sound you want. I like the lo-fi, but I still like to have a little bump in them. Here I'm just kind of looking at the overall EQ. I thought it needed some highs, so I'm just listening right now, just kind of seeing what sounds good, and I'll raise it up a little bit. And then because it's a two-track overall, I'll probably bring it back down. Here I'm just cutting out some of the mud at the bottom. And trying to get it to sound right. So yeah, I'm just now trying to get my routing kind of right between coming from the tracks into the aux, then into the master bus, master channel there, the red. So now I'm deciding that I want to route from
my main mix. So my main mix, that two track is going into an aux bus. And the aux bus is going out to the master bus. But now I want to come out of that aux bus and go into another aux to give it a little chorus effect. For some reason, and lately, over the years, I've noticed, but I just like chorus effect on my beats. It just gives it something. So I just want to bring that beat out of the aux into another aux and send them independent back into the master. But I just want to add a little something to, a little effect to the beat. So I am now, doing some rerouting. That's what you see me doing there. That chorus plugin is a Arteria plugin that I'm using. Right now, I don't really know. I have a favorite chorus plugin. At this time, I would say though, there's one in Reason Studio that I really like, but haven't been using Reasons too much these days. So you see me here. I'm just trying to get my routing right there. Yeah, I want to make sure both of those aux are going to the main master out independently. And so now I'm just messing around with the mix where I want that chorus effect in there, but not so noticeable, but enough for it to be felt rather than noticed. So on that chorus, I'm thinking just to give it a little bit more, I want to throw a delay on top of that chorus. So I just add it in the Box Pro Tools plugin of delay plugin. I place on there to give it a little something. So this track, what I'll do is probably upload it on my BeatStar page for a free download. If you wanna get the get this beat, get this instrumental, certainly you can. You can do it for free. Just look, it'll be a link on the YouTube page here where you can do that. So Ozone, now getting into the final mix. The mastering portions of it. I'm just now kind of I'm checking for overall volume. I like to be around that 12 or loudness, integrated loudness number. I like to be around 10, 11, or 12. Somewhere up in there. 12, though, is kind of my range, what I like. Like it to be. So I'm looking at the EQ here. I think I noticed in this record, I did boost the highs and I might have caused some things. So I'm trying to just edge it back a little bit on the, on the master mix. So I see at the end there, there's some, you could tread out, drop off there visually. So I'm just trying to take some of that, just all of that out, doing a brick wall cut. And I'm trying to think, aim for like maybe 16, 17 on the cut up there up top in the frequency. So I believe that's it, and thank you for watching. Go download it, man, and you'll be added to my my email list at the same time. This is Smell, peace and love. Hear me in the wind.